Make a date with Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
This is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei of Living Streams International, bringing you matters of faith with Graphic Online. Living Streams International, we meet behind the trade fair behind Zenith College on Sundays from 7 to 9 for first service and 10 to 12 for second service. And then on Wednesdays for our midweek service, 6:30 to 8 o'clock. Make a date with us and come hear a revelatory word, a life-changing word. Just come and enjoy with us. This morning, I'd like to capture my thoughts with boat comforts. You know, in Matthew chapter 14, verse 25 to 31, there is a story there. For me, it's a hilarious story, and it's a very interesting story, but it's hilarious also for me. Because, of course, you know, the main player there, you know, the player there is Peter. Loud mouth, big mouth Peter, who shoots his mouth sometimes before he thinks. But that's Peter for you, you know. And the Bible says now Jesus Christ had finished a very powerful crusade. And after the crusade, he had told the people, now you go over there and take a boat and then go. I'll meet you at the other side. You just go. And the Bible said now he had gone somewhere to pray. And the disciples then just started, they sat in the boat and then they began to go. And of course, there was a little bit of an upheaval. A faith-shaking upheaval over there. But right in the midst of this thing, they saw Jesus walking on the water. Wow. Jesus was walking on the water. And you know, and all of a sudden, the first thing they said is, no, it's not him, he's a ghost. So you know something? we are not the only superstitious people. They started talking about ghosts a long time, in the long time before we started talking about ghosts. But they said, this is not Jesus, it is a ghost. And then Peter made a statement, Lord, if it is you, and that means Peter said, look, if it is you, let me come to you. Now, here's the thing. Peter said, I am not going to take anything for the sake of taking it. I'm going to investigate it. They are saying it is a ghost that is going to create fear, but I need to investigate it. I need to understand what is going on. I need to investigate it. So he made a statement. If it is you, that is an investigative statement, let me come to you. If it is real, that so we must look for the truth in issues. We must look for the facts in issues, not just what people hear, not just hearsay, not just people's opinions, but we must look for the truth. He said, if it is you, let me come to you. And surprisingly, Jesus said, Peter, come. And Peter got out of the boat. The other disciples were in the boat, but Peter got out of the boat. And Peter began to walk on the water, one step after the other, one step after the other. Yeah, finally, you know, Peter, began to doubt that, hey, what is this? You get it, and then began to sink. But of all the disciples, only one person has an experience. And that experience was birthed out of an investigative mentality. And then secondly, with the mentality, I'm not going to accept the status quo. I am not going to accept the status quo. And then the third one is, I'm going to step out of my comfort zone. And that person was Peter. He was the one who walked on the water. All of us read about it. Those who saw it too, they saw it, but they never walked on the water. But it was Peter who walked on the water. So we read about it. The three things that marked Peter, he said, I'm going to investigate. First of all, I refuse to accept what everybody else is saying. That it is a ghost. I refuse to accept it. Don't just accept things because people said it. No. But sometimes our mind must be investigative enough to find out the truth for ourselves. And that's what Peter said. He said, I need to find out for myself. So he said, Lord, if it is you, let me come to you. When Jesus said, come, then Peter did one great thing. He got out of the boat. In life, each and every one of us have our comfort zones. And sometimes we do not want to take risk. And sometimes we do not want to step out of our comfort zones. and we are glued to our comfort zones and we'll never see any miracle, or we'll never go to the next level of our lives where we'll experience abundance, where we'll experience things that others in our family might not have done before, because we stayed in our comfort zone. If you do not dare to step out of your comfort zone, you ain't going to get anything from God. Those who believe in God must first believe that He is, and He's a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. That is a continual process of seeking, searching for God. Listen, there are things that God will want to do with our lives. There are blessings He wants to give to us, but we cannot get those blessings or get the experiential aspect of those blessings unless we come out of our comfort zones. This is what Peter did. He stepped out of his comfort zone, and for the rest of his life, you get it? Others may condemn him, and Peter fell, he collapsed in the sea. None of them walked on the sea. The experience of walking on the sea, the singular experience of walking on the sea, the bragging rights belongs to Peter. What about you? You see, you can be tied to your comfort zone. You never want to take risk. You never want to step out of your comfort zone. You like the this thing. Man, if we want to see great things for God, if we want to see God do great things in our life, sometimes we need to come out of our comfort zone. Sometimes you have to be an Elijah praying down for fire. Don't ask me, I've not done it before. Sometimes you need to step out by faith and do something for God. This is what it is. Step out of your comfort zone, your zone of doubt and unbelief, your zone of self-preservation and self-security. Sometimes you need to step out of it to see God do something powerful in your life. Boats of comfort will be limitations. Step out. See you later.